Hello and welcome to TAIK. In this video, we are going to explore the features of quadrant chart in Power BI. I have made a simple quadrant chart in Power BI. It's profit and sales by quantity by region. And one more thing is profit and sales and quantity by category. So let's create a new page to begin with this. Click on the plus sign on the below. You will get a new page and go to the visualization on the right side. Click on the quadrant chart. If you don't find this quadrant chart visuals on the visualization menu, just click on the three dots on the right side, import a custom visual. You have the two options here. One is import from file. That is, if you have already downloaded the file, you can import it from your desktop or PC. Or you can directly import from the marketplace. For this, you need to sign in to the Microsoft account and then you can download the visual. I already downloaded this one, so I will just click on this quadrant chart, and I just want to make sure the size of the chart is as per my requirement. So I will change this one. So what I will do is just go back to this one, see the what are the options. I have take x-axis on the profit and y is on the sales. So let's go back to this one, click on these visuals. So here are the tables and fields available here. So I will just click on the profit, drag and drop to in the x-axis, and the total sales on the y-axis, and by region, right? So I'll just click the region in the legend axis. And if you notice, the size of the bubbles is the same for all the regions, that is north, south, east, west. And if you want to change the shape of the bubble, that is based on the quantity what we have sold, so I just drag this quantity in the radial axis. See, the size of the bubbles has been changed to this one. And let's resume the formatting. So here are the options available for the format. So I will go one by one. The first one is the legend. Legend should be on the top position, bottom left. We have given many options here, so I will keep this the top option. If you want to be on the center screen, then just click on the top center. This one, legend. I think it's better to be on the top on the left side, so I will keep this one. And the title. The title should be, I think we should keep the title, so I'll just keep it on. The color of the title. And the size, I'll just increase the size to 10. Just close this one, and then the quadrant option. We have the four options, so we can set the name for it. So what I will say is, it is high sales, high profit. The second one is high sales, but low profit. The third one is low sales and low profit. And the last one is low sales, but high profit. And if we go down further, you have two lines here. So 80,000 and 40,000 for our visualization purpose. So if you want to change this one, we can change this angle for our analytic purpose. So what I will do is, I will just change it to 60,000. So the line, center line will change. I'll keep it as it is, so 80,000. And the lines would be on the dotted lines, or if you want to be on the plain line, so we'll keep the plain line itself. That look nice. And the next axis, we can change the title if you want, and visible off or on. And I want to change it to profit. And the labels, the margin, it has to be as per my idea. So I will go back to this one. Y axis is also the same option, so just change the name, this profit, and then sales. And the bubble color, I will keep the default one. And the title, so the profit sales, sales and profit, profit and sales, and quantity by region. If you want to be overdraft, this is recently introduced the overdraft option in the latest version of Power BI for the June release. So what we will do is, if you keep it on, and if your visual is smaller than this one, so it will automatically come to this next line. That's cool, right? So I'll just reshape again. So I will keep it on. The font color I would like to be black, and I want to change the background color a little bit, and then I'll change the alignment, change size, and even the font family. They have some limitations on the font family, but just click on this one, bold a little bit, and then the option is background. Turn down the background. I will keep the background to be on the white, and the transparency level, if you want to change, you can. Lock aspect ratio, but if you want to lock these visuals at their place, okay. And then the general is just the alignment of the visual on the x-axis and the y-axis. So I will keep it as a 10. You won't see the many difference on the y-axis. If they are, say for example, I'm just putting 10, so you can see the movement of it. I will keep this one. And the width of this, so I'll keep the 600. It's pretty simple. Even we can do it by mouse click and drag and drop. And they are giving the option also here. And the border, beyond this one, and radius. This is a cool thing, right? So if you want to change the radius, the edge of the visuals, so it is changing slightly. I'll just keep this one for length and border. So that's it for this one. So what I will do is I will just there are two options for this. If you want to make the second quadrant the same look like, but only the fields will change. So just copy this, Control C, and then paste it anywhere else, Control V. Just drag and drop for this. I will put this here, and you can change. You can click the category and then just drop to the region area. That's it. It will change everything automatically. One more. This is so simple, right? Even you can do it one more way. I will just click on this and then I will remove this one. And you just begin from start. Just click on this visual and put it manually. Legend on the category. So we'll pop it on the x axis. So sales on the y axis. Quantity on the radial axis, and then just click on the previous visual. Click on the format painter on the home menu. It will copy the format and all, and just come to this one. You see the brush symbol, and then click on this second visual. So it brings all the features from the first visual to this visual. Cool feature, right? Even you can copy it from the previous slide. So copy it, right? Okay, you can do this by this copy, Control C and Control V, it is copy. If you want to copy the image, just go back to this one, copy and paste. You can do it on either way. If you want to add a new image, you just click on the new image tab on the home menu. You can just click on that. Ask you to open it from the system. You want to download the picture, whatever you want, you can do this one. And the text box is already here. What I will do is anywhere on the page, just go to the format option and the page background. I want to give the page background to be a little bit gray, and the gray should be 50%. Okay, and just make it a little bit extra on there. Genre is 54, 25, so 45. This should be 625. Okay. That's it.
To this channel, please don't forget to click on the subscribe button. If you like the video, please click on the thumbs up button and share with your friends and comments below.